Gee, cannot assign ministers and laws.
Yeah, they're not doing very well. You cannot do laws. Great start there, Spain. All right, so we're playing some Hearts of Iron 4 multiplayer, just me and Chris this time, but you know, sometimes having to have three players kind of gets a little bit more cumbersome, so just having two sometimes is pretty nice, because, like, we are going to be going for the thing where we both go monarchist, and we both go for the Bourbons, and we make our alliance. Where is it at? I've not played with the French tree at all. The two countries, two crowns. But, and we start the... We make our own faction. The Legitimist Alliance. Great. Great name, guys.
Referring to anything involving Spain and the Spanish Civil War as legitimist is baffling.
Yeah. And any ruler of France, pretty much ever. yeah, we're gonna start that faction, and just having two countries that are kind of that, and then we probably just make a bunch of puppets or whatever. Makes more sense than being like France, Spain, and Portugal. It's like, I say that. I don't know, I feel like it's kind of a little more fitting to only have these two and then they conquer the two, rather than just having these two and, like, non-aligned Portugal again. Like, that feels kind of tacked on, so I feel like this is kind of cool. One day we would love to get back to the, Kami Germany campaign, but that probably won't be for a bit. And one of these days, we're going to need to get back to the Czechoslovakian tanks as well.
Oh, God.
And I don't blame him. I don't blame him for thinking the tanks are just kind of good as a whole, but... All right, so what is the first thing I want to do is France? All right, what are our problems?
Everything.
Yeah, Victor's the Great War, land doctrine research speed minus 75%, disjoint a government, ugh, Maginot line, recruitable population decrease, political violence, and post-World War II really has been the best time for France ever, hasn't it? At least it's not like, at least when they riot against the government and destroy, like, the entirety of Paris, people don't actually die.
Well, they've had a lot of practice destroying the entirety of Paris themselves.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, they're very careful about it. Alright, civilian factories...
Whatever political ideology is popular in France is not popular in Paris.
Yeah. Alright, I would love... Okay, let's do a couple military factories as well. Like, what's the percentage of population that lives in Paris compared to the rest of France?
No clue.
Like, Paris Metro, that's probably a better way of saying it.
Let's Google.
Yeah. Alright.
Population of the Paris metropolitan area is... A little more than 12.5 million.
Nice. Population of
66.9 million is the population of France.
Okay, well, yeah, I was about to say, like, is that only European France? But the rest of France is not really that relevant to the population. So it's, like, you said 66?
Mm-hmm.
That's about...
67.
So if we just do some rounding, that's about 12? About...
A fifth,
yeah, I was getting my... My numbers crossed. Well, I mean, that's significant, but not. It's not like... That's a country that's, like, almost entirely one city. And a big city.
Singapore.
Yeah, well, I mean, isn't that, like, a city-state?
It is the city.
Yeah, exactly. I was trying to think of more, like... All right, but anyway, the path that I want to do in order to get become non-aligned is that I have to do...
I think it's the national block.
Yeah. Now, France's thing is cool in that you can go like a right-wing or a left-wing democracy. That's something they're better at these days, rather than just like, oh, here's the left-wing path, you're going full-on commie. Or, here's the right-wing path, you're gonna be best friends with Hitler. No, you can actually just be... There are middle grounds. Alright. Revive the national bloc. The political landscape is growing more and more radical by the day. The left whispers of making common cause with the communists. What is needed now is strong, stable leadership. Strong and stable. Strong and... stable. All right, let's select all of our dudes.
Gallibon.
Start your drilling, boys. Actually, let's get all the guys that are don't need drilling. In a different army.
Gotta love that France is on their fifth republic.
Oh yeah.
Gallibon.
Hey man, if it broke,
écoutez.
Break some more. All right, get up to. You can probably do speed. You want to do the speed 3 front right now?
Yeah.
All right, and we need tech. Wow, our weapons and equipment are. We don't even have the 1918 stuff. Always got to get the research and. Go construction speed. How are we doing as far as equipment goes? Not great, but not awful. Alright, I am, oh, and you guys too. Got troops all over everywhere. It's like we've got, like a global empire or something. Alright, where else do I have dudes? Oh, that's right, Syria. There we go. Yep, I'm right on pause if you are.
Yep.
Alright, let's see what everyone's doing. England. Alright, we have to let the day tick first, I think. Revisit colonial policy.
Good for us.
Yeah, that's nice. Alright, Netherlands. They're already doing form new government. I don't think I've ever seen them choose a political path. I've seen them cave to the British, but I don't even know if they've done anything after that. Portugal's reorganizing the army. Western focus in Yugoslavia, dictatorship in Romania. They're doing economic intervention in Hungary.
Always do economic intervention. I'd like to see them do something other than economic intervention. Can't they just once balance their damn budget? Bulgaria's tree is pretty big now.
Yeah. So how have you been liking the new Yugoslavia changes?
Pretty good, except for the... I just have no clue how you're supposed to be able to side with the British. I mean, like, I know you can do it through the and the regency thing. But you don't get the option to have the royal wedding until, like, after 1941.
Wow.
And World War II starts in 1939, and in a couple months of World War II starting, if you're not part of the Allies, Britain just declares war on you.
Man.
So, as far as I can tell, the only way to side with Britain is for Germany to declare war on you in 1938.
Huh.
Other than that, it's really good.
Alright. But why a skull? It's like with the national block, we've got the torch, the flag, and the skull. Are we the baddies?
But yeah, for like Yugoslavia, attract Axis capital and attract Allied capital are not mutually exclusive to each other.
That makes sense.
Once you pick either friendship treaty or reinforced old alliances, you can do both and then do either the limited self-government or evolution. So the evolution track keeps you as one country for the entirety. But the cost of that is that the debuffs aren't depowered completely.
Gotcha.
And you gain temporary debuffs on top of it. So you're more stable, but you're less powerful.
Strong or stable.
You balkanize the hell out of the Balkans.
Yeah.
Attention. It's not that bad though, because it gets you some nice, it gets you some free troops.
Yeah. Oh, no, it looks like I can intervene somehow. Okay, I get. Once the Spanish Civil War starts, I can do intervention in the Spanish Civil War decisions. So it looks like I could just do it whenever. Once I do my one focus that I'm doing right now.
I've never seen the AI oppose Hitler.
I don't think I have either.
Gardez vos rangs.
Turkey has a demilitarized zone now?
Yeah. Deed the do.
Ooh, yep. Their tree's massive.
Yeah.
So Greece is the smallest tree of the three, then?
Probably, yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna be right back. I gotta run down and grab something.
Okay. Alright, and what is our infantry division looking like? We could... How many... artillery do we have? They're lacking.
Okay, back to the complete collapse of Spanish society.
So Tuesday.
Yep.
You back?
Yeah.
Just making sure you're back. I just, Greece's tree is definitely the shortest, but it is also the widest, if that makes any difference.
I have no idea.
It's like, it doesn't go quite as long as the other ones, but it does have, like, more options earlier, I suppose. That's a way of seeing it. But as far as number of focuses to do, probably is the shortest.
Up election.
Nice. So did Steve actually get back to you about when he was, if he was gonna join in?
He's I mean, Mike.
Okay. Alright, Mexico's going exile Calles.
Smart move.
All right, well, he says he's going to be pulling up the stream.
Okay, now I've got stuff.
Yo, biggest YouTube, thanks for joining me. Thank you, good streams, good, thank you. You've got a good YouTube. Yeah. It'll be a wonderful day when there's a reason to look at what Italy and Russia are doing for the trees. Oh, Japan's going for the shogunate.
Cool.
Which is not uncommon.
Are they actually going for the shogunate, or...?
Well, they've gone support the Koda faction.
I've seen them actually go shogunate once after they've supported the Koda faction.
Okay. I don't know what they if they've done the Showa... Restoration. They're doing challenges Zaibatsu's right now.
I have no idea how I should garrison these places. Attention!
Super quiet.
Écoutez. Gardez vos rangs. Aux ordres. Gardez vos rangs. Gardez vos rangs.
All right, remilitarization of the Rhineland. Want to go to war?
I'm gonna be at war, so regardless, so it's up to you.
Man, I'm not ready. I'm tempted. There is a colonial policy. I'm not gonna do anything. All right, Britain is guiding the colonies now. Gonna go utilize the leagues. It is a sad fact that political violence has been commonplace in France. If the country is to survive the threat of communist revolution, we must not shy away from the help of people who can meet, who can and will meet the communist thugs in the streets. The street, if it comes to that. And it sounds like very familiar rhetoric. Alright, Hungary at the moment is going to strengthen fascism.
Gardez-vous. Vos ordres. Paré. Vos ordres. Gardez vos rangs. Paré. Ordre. Aux ordres. Paré. Attention.
Where is Lions? Vietnam, nice and compliant, as usual. What are you up to right now, Chris?
What?
What are you up to right now?
Trying to not get completely obliterated in the coming civil war.
Okay. Like, specifically?
I'm trying to do all these, like, decisions.
Gotcha.
Currently, I'm having Primo de Rivera give a speech.
Écoutez. Écoutez. Attention. Écoutez.
me at all?
What was that?
John?
Say again? What was that?
Can you hear me?
Yeah. I turned up your volume on Discord a little bit.
Okay, because Steve is saying that he can't hear me.
Okay. I mean, he's just watching the stream right now.
President just got fired.
Very cool. Election. Communists in government. Communist movement in France, fueled by broad dissatisfaction among the working class and radical trends among academics, has grown large enough to lead to the formation of several parties. After one of these has gained considerable support in the current election, politicians in Parti Radical have started debating whether or not to seek their support in forming a government. Although they consider our democratic institutions to be little more than bourgeois tyranny, They seem eager to make the changes they want to see through cooperating with the government rather than overthrowing it. I mean, I'm gonna kick out the commies anyway. And I lose stability. I think I will just not lose the stability. I'll keep them in for now.
Regardez vos rangs.
Looks like Bulgaria is going against the dictatorship. Whether they're going democratic or communist.
Attention. Écoutez. Gardez vos rangs. Attention. Écoutez.
Now, let's gain this. I want to start gaining stability. I think I want to start gaining stability. Although, yeah, let's go agricultural protectionism. The world economy is growing more and more hostile to our traditional ways of production. We do not take measures to protect our farmers, we will soon face a crisis of untold proportions as our farmers are still unable to remain competitive in the face of mass-produced foodstuffs coming in from overseas. I like that more than laissez-faire, because laissez-faire just gives faster industrial tech, which is like, very short-term kind of bump. Because you're going to be ahead of time on industry stuff anyway. Like, you just do the couple industry techs and then you're just kind of waiting to do the rest of them. Unless you're super hardcore into... Like, I don't even bother with synthetics all that much. Like, you do boom, boom, boom. Yeah, I mean, yeah. It's not a huge deal. Personally. Could be wrong.
Attention. Gardez vos rangs. Gardez vos rangs. écouter. Écoutez. Attention. Gardez vos rangs. Attention. Attention. Gardez vos rangs. Écoutez. Attention. Gardez vos rangs. Vos ordres. Gardez vos rangs.
Okay, recruiting Franco. That seems like a decent idea.
Hey. I don't get why I've got two division templates that are completely identical. Oh, I'm sorry. One of them has a shovel, the other one doesn't. I'm gonna be a little silly and give the one that doesn't have the shovel the icon for the shovels. Heh heh. Because that's how disorganized the French military is. Well, it took him long enough. Or, well, I mean, we are at a slower speed. I feel like July isn't too strange.
Attention. Gardez vos rangs. Écoutez.
You gotta wonder what the unaligned party is at this point in France. It's like we've got 56% democracy, 30% communist, and then 13% non-aligned. Are those just non-voters? Monarchists? I mean, it's just called non-aligned. Like, the party has no name. I honestly don't think there are 13% monarchists in France at this point.
That's all I got.
Like, you'd think there'd be more in England, but there are none.
Maybe they're the people who just don't show up to vote.
Meanwhile, in America, 99% Democratic Party. Bulgaria is going communist. Greece is going either communist or democracy or fascist. That really narrows it down. But they're going for the bring home the exiled versus the monarchist, which could go kind of either a non-aligned or fascist monarchist. Mexico is enforcing the Calles law.
And after they went through all the trouble of kicking him out, too.
Yeah. Communist influence foreign policy. Communists often consider themselves a part of an international revolution, and our choice to accept them as partners in our government has drawn the attention of many of their international allies. Representatives of communist parties maintain close ties to nations which have abandoned our form of government in favor of a dictatorship of the proletariat. Ties which you may need to acknowledge in French foreign policy if we wish to retain their support. Eh, sure. Keep that stability as high as we can for the moment. Alright. Oh, I see.
They're purging.
Yeah. Alright.
That'll be helpful. Okay. War starts in 2 days.
Okay, I will wait for that then, and I will see if I can support you. Or do I want to support you yet? Because you're going to start off as the fascists.
I have no idea.
I don't... I can't even do that one quite yet, but I'm going to go ahead and do the Council of Rambouillet. With the country in turmoil, the people look for a strong leader. It has become clear that republicanism has failed the French people, and it is time for the natural rulers of France to return. But first, the groundwork must be laid for a restoration of the monarchy. What's up?
So I hear the Spanish Civil War.
Yeah.
It started.
Okay, I've come in here for a little bit. If you need any advice.
Yeah, you can stick around as long as you want, dude.
I'm probably gonna need a lot of advice.
Oh. Okay, one sec.
It did not hold the South at all.
I tried.
Oh man, you're in a bad position. So yeah, you are coming up way louder here than you are on this stream.
Huh. I mean, could it be because the volume on your that you have the stream at is lower?
Huh.
I've never seen nationalist Spain start out with a worse spot than what you just got, Chris.
Yeah, I was doing the influence thing, like one after another. And the thing is, the Republicans, you know, all those decisions. Yes.
Yeah. I'd have to check that. They might. It's kind of confusing the way it works. Because they're not actually taking more than one decision at a time, I don't think. It's really hard to get anything else in the game.
Gardez vos rangs. Attention.
So what you have to your advantage, Chris, is that I guess this isn't really an advantage, but can't move around very well, but their troops can't move around very well either, so.
This is not going to be fun.
So all that stuff in the south, forget about it. Focus on the north coast first.
That's what I was thinking.
Oh, this is really important.
Yes.
Because you're going to be going with the Bourbons, right?
Yeah, we're going Bourbon.
The what?
So that, yeah. You're going with
The Carlists.
The Carlists? Yeah. So you do not want to lose Burgos, I think it is.
I was looking at the thing. Burgos is the one. One it says to control.
Murcia, I want to say, in northwestern Spain, that's going to go Falange. Unless you can somehow prevent it from splitting. I don't know if it's possible.
I don't think so.
I mean, historically, it shouldn't split. I don't believe. I think if you play historically, National Spain will remain whole.
Yeah, it does. I'm just trying to organize everything right now, so...
In a way. But because you have such a small amount of territory compared to the Republic, it's going to be tougher than usual.
Yeah, all my good soldiers ended up in Africa.
Wait, really?
Yeah.
That sucks.
So I'm gonna have to get them.
On the bright side, you've got Gibraltar.
Hold on to Gibraltar.
My rock.
Forget about Gibraltar. Well,
I'm just gonna have them march out of Gibraltar. You know, why the hell not? What do I have to lose, right?
Could we unpause, but at like a slower speed, maybe?
Wait, do you have... Oh, yep. So Britain gave it back to you. Okay, that's fun. It happened to me in my first Spain playthrough. You might want to play at speed one for a little bit while the Spanish Civil War starts setting up.
All right, I'm going to turn down speed one, and you ready on pause? Because I'm just kind of sitting here. Hello? Anyone there? Can you guys hear me?
Yep, can hear you.
Okay, could we unpause?
And at speed one, honestly, it's gonna work really easy for you. For at least at first.
Okay, I'm going to unpause.
Hear you. Can you hear us?
I can now. Connection seems to be pretty crappy right now. Alright, I am unpausing.
Go ahead.
I'm gonna start up the game, see if I can go into spec.
Okay.
The repeating voices is kind of confusing.
And I'm fine with turning up the speed whenever you are.
Let's wait at the moment.
Oh, fuck. Okay, not going to be starting up the game yet, because here there is an update. Let me see if I start downloading. How long is that? How much?
It's probably only like a hot fix for some stuff.
Might be the big
probably
one.
Probably the big one. Steam up
oh, you haven't actually opened it yet.
Okay. Yeah, 739 mega. Nope.
was all the...
So, Chris, my big recommendation for you is doing whatever you can to regain mobility for your troops.
Yeah, that's what I'm working on. I saw the focus.
Gardez vos rangs. Gardez vos rangs. Écoutez. Aux ordres. Attention. Attention. Gardez vos rangs. Attention. Parez. Écoutez. Attention. Parez. Attention. Parez. Attention. Aux ordres. Attention.
So how goes the war? I mean, you're kind of lobbing out in the south a little. That's not bad.
I was able to connect that enclave with the port.
Good.
I got so. I should, for the most part, be able to hold that little weird L.
Mm-hmm.
Which is good because that diverts a bunch of their troops.
Yeah.
Keep in mind that as they get stronger, it's going to be harder and harder to hold on to your smaller territories like that. Right now, you should be able to do it pretty easily. Like, if you look at the amount of time it'll take for a battle to end.
Could we turn up the speed too, maybe?
Yeah, Chris, notice all your fights take a look at them. It should be like 500 days before. You should be good with speed too now that the now that your front lines are kind of like solo.
I'll turn up the speed by one.
What if I?
They mostly have.
Is there any way that you can make a division between the two ports?
Sanjuro dies.
Alright, you're doing well pushing up in the north.
God. Battle will last for 2,374
Yeah, the battle's days. A little slow starting out.
Yay, the Olympics. How many Spains do you think got teams during the Olympics? The anarchist team was actually just a crate full of rabid Wolverines.
Oh, it was 1936. No, Spain boycotted.
Both of them?
Yeah, the People's Olympiad in Barcelona. Oh, never was held because of the...
Alright, you're not doing half bad.
Spanish Civil War broke out.
Sorry.
Speed 3 now, maybe?
John,
mm-hmm.
How goes...
Say again?
Your quest to be able to help me.
Okay, I'll do that one after this, after I finish this focus.
Well, I probably shouldn't. Flange's loyalties, so.
Yeah. You know those Pokemon, like, fuser things online? It's like when you put one Pokemon, like, wait, Pokemon.
The worst of the three.
It might really be bad.
What exactly? What's bad? Our connection is awful right now. Like, I am hearing snippets of some things you sometimes say.
Okay, I'm gonna mute myself so I can turn on the... I'm gonna drop out of the chat for a minute so I can listen to the actual stream again for a little bit.
Okay.
I'll pop back on if I see something horrible.
Which you probably will.
Which probably will.
Okay, I think we can go up to speed.
Okay, go for it.
Three.
It's not looking bad.
Thank you.
Arriveront.
Well, I captured Sevilla.
Nice.
Yeah.
You're so close to connecting a lot of your borders. Vladimir's Gulag. How's it going? Thanks for joining me. So, I'm playing as France. Going to be going for Bourbon stuff. Chris is playing as Nationalist Spain and will be going for the Carlists. Nah, it's only going to be us friends that are doing it. Sorry.
Sorry, my front line got messed up.
I'm just not interested in playing with anyone that I don't know at the moment. Thank you. Britain continues to be doing their decolonization stuff. It's funny that there's that in Romania, that going down the pro-Axis path leads to a democratic ending with King Michael's coup. All right, there we go. Intervention in Spain. The civil war in Spain has brought the clash between ideologies to our very doorstep. We must tread carefully lest the conflict spill over into our country. And this is a shorter focus, too. I've only got... Hold on. Only 29 days left. I don't know what these decisions will be, though. I'm really surprised how that bulge, pretty much in the very center of enemy territory, is still around. Who needs stability? It's only a number.
How very French.
Mm-hmm. All right, excellent job in the north.
Attention.
Got more non-aligned support now than I have communists, so that's great. How's that dude that's encircled doing?
Ugh. We'll get there.
Alright, well, we connected the stuff down in the south. That's pretty good. Any chance we could go up to speed 4?
Not right now.
All right, my focus is almost finished.
Écoutez.
Alright, there we go. Revise the Constitution. The Republican Constitution was always intended to be a stopgap measure that has been allowed to persist for far too long. Now we will rewrite it to allow a monarch to return. Alright, what are these decisions now? Alright, here we go. Intervention in the Spanish Civil War. Groups all across the political spectrum want to intervene in the Spanish Civil War in one way or another. However, there is considerable concern that the war may spread to our country if we take too open a stance in support of one side. We must be careful to tread a narrow path. We want to ensure that a friendly government is left in control of Spain. Everything I do lowers my stability. I could send you equipment. What is this? What is non-intervention committee? If I had enough war support, I could just straight up join. No. I'm just gonna go for getting rid of the disjointed government.
Okay.
I think that may be... my stability issue is becoming a problem. I'm just unable to really do much of anything. Thank you.
Okay, I've almost cleaned up the north.
Very good. What will happen if I invite the Soviet Union to the non-intervention committee? Try that. And they join. Calling it a vital...
intervening.
Exactly. Calling it a vital step to ending the violence...
they left.
Yeah.
I think he's leaving.
Yeah. Calling it a vital step to ending the violence in Spain, the Soviet Union is formally signed on to the non-intervention committee. Whether or not they actually honor its terms remains to be seen. So I gain some stability and lose a little war... support, but that's fine. That's a better direction to be going right now. I'm not too worried about war support at the moment. Despite it all.
Well, he's still here, but he's not fighting me anymore.
That's good. France wins again.
Oh. Take a look at Republican Spain at the focus they're doing.
Autogestion?
Look where it is.
Oh. Oh, they're going anarchist.
Yeah.
All right, so... Wow. And a K in Espagne. Come sometime, 4K.
Thank you.
All right. So Portugal is going for the right wing trees. Or democratic. Gonna hard to see. They are not going communist, what we are certain of.
So we want to hope that they join the Carlist fight.
Maybe. Or you kill them, or whatever your tree allows you to get. Like, you might be able to get cores on them. Yeah, restore the Iberian Union. Wait, no, hold on. Yes, you could do that. Which I'd... that maybe... It's either puppeting or, like, an annexation. I don't know. Focus finished. Alright, what to do next? I want to just go right for...
Okay, I like the name of Greece's Democratic Party.
Oh, yeah, it's a good one. Okay, I need to wait a year, I think, before I can actually become the dude. Before I can get rid of disjointed government.
Well, Russia hasn't left.
Hmm. I'm going to devalue the franc. While other countries allowed their currencies to become less valuable to help their economies, we have steadfastly refused to do so. As a result, our economy is lagging behind others. If we want to become more competitive and weather the coming storm, we must not dismiss a devaluation of our currency out of hand. Even if we would prove, even if it would prove to be an unpopular measure. Oh, you finally lost that dude that was in the center, huh?
Yep.
He's a brave soldier.
Yep.
Britain's going commie. Mexico's going for some red shirts.
Anything else you can do to help?
Let's see. What would actually be helpful? Non-military aid, which send 100 support equipment to you, I think. I don't think that would be that useful. I could, those Spanish factions purchase weapons from us. I mean, how are you doing on guns?
I could use more.
I mean, I barely have.
I could also use more support equipment.
Okay. I'll give you the support equipment, or allow you to. I don't know exactly what that does. Like, I clicked a button, but I don't know how it can actually give it to you.
Spain's not given up till it has 5% of its victory points.
Yeah. You may be doing this for a bit.
Yep. Yeah. 90 days until I split.
Alright.
I believe I'm gonna take the strip down the center.
Alright.
So, like, cut the nation into thirds horizontally.
Okay. Our first step in rebuilding our industries must be to improve our industrial base in our continental holdings. Is this the focus? Is that, are you doing the focus now that's gonna split you?
No, there's a timer. I split regardless of whether or not. But I'm going to do that one next because it gives me a bonus.
Okay.
And there we go.
Yeah, that's a hefty commune.
Yeah, it knocked out a bunch of my territory.
Huh.
Well, better try and fix this before I die.
You do have quite the squeeze on regular Spain, though.
Hold on, this screwed up my lines. Gotta fix it.
Looks like Canada wants a break from Britain.
Well, Britain did go communist, so...
Yeah. Ooh. Well... So... Portugal is going fascist.
Wonderful. Well, I guess we'll just have to crush them.
Yep. Spain is going to try and petition for my aid. Hmm. Oh, and Canada's going fascist.
So we get to see Vampire Vincent Price.
Mm-hmm. Bike sniffer, bike seat sniffer supreme. It's the Hindenburg. So do you know how long it will be before you break off?
I believe 15 days.
Oof. You're doing so well, too.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go. I could just send... Alright. Hold on. I will wait until you break off before I send any support equipment. We're doing pretty well, considering he had a pretty bad positioning at the beginning. There it is. Oof.
Yeah, no. Yep.
Big oof.
Yep.
Here, have 100 band-aids or whatever.
Okay, this is going to be a little more difficult. But it looks like I kept most of the troops.
Well, that's good.
Well, at least Steve's enjoying this. This might not be as bad as it looks.
That's good.
Hmm.
No, now I get the notification.
Could you slow it down, John?
Okay. How much longer do you think you want to go for? Because I haven't had dinner yet.
What?
How long do you think you want to be going for?
I don't know.
Oh yeah, Egypt's independent. I see a nice encirclement there. Has Portugal sent volunteers to the other guy?
What?
Has Portugal sent volunteers to the directory?
Probably. I think I lost all of my volunteers, two of them, so.
Okay. Protect the rights of man. They may never say it openly, but it is obvious to anyone with eyes to see. Curtailing the right to property is just the first step to eliminating all the rights our proud ancestors fought so hard for. We will not, have it. Yeah, but who gets the property? The right to property sounds like you're going to be giving it away to everybody. Spain requests aid. Though the political situation in Spain has long been unstable, it appears that the severity of the conflict has taken the Spanish government by surprise. They have requested any aid we can muster to help them in their fight against fascism, and urge us to not delay dally. Same thing, really. Too long in this critical time. It is doubtful whether the Republican government can win the current civil war without outside assistance. And though the victory of a democratic Spain would be a desirable outcome, it is likely that providing this aid would encourage communist sympathizers in our own country. Absolutely not. We cannot risk our own political stability to aid them. They have very little territory anyway. Aaron, you've just about got a pretty stable front. Alright, would we be able to turn the speed up?
No, I'm micromanaging everything.
Okay. Kind of impressed with the anarchists. No, Amelia. You got the fascists pinned.
They got the land, but I got the army.
Yeah. Yo, I've got 69 factories. Nice.
Attention. Attention. Aux ordres.
I just like the idea that the anarchists just always pull crazy pranks on other countries. Like, it's like Italy expected to hear from the anarchist ambassador, but it was actually just a moose.
Yeah, Portugal has volunteers at for the directory.
Cursed Portuguese.
As, I believe, do Germany and Italy.
Eh. Alright, let's see if I can fix that. I did not think about that one. Okay, I cannot do that anymore, I cannot stop them joining in. Maybe I can only do one of those, and I used it on the Soviets. On the bright side, my factory output is no longer in the negatives. Percentage, like it's got a net positive in, yeah. If baseline is zero, we were doing worse than average. Now we are doing slightly above average, is all I'm saying. Thank you. Turkey hasn't even demilitarized Istanbul yet. They're going for, like, making a custom tank.
Well, there's no point demilitarizing stuff if you've got no military.
Yeah, I guess that's a logic. And Greece is going communist.
A lot of people going communist.
Yeah.
Who would have thought that the most deadly enemies would be the anarchists?
Yeah.
I mean, besides Trump.
Oh, yeah. They're everywhere. The highly organized anarchists are spreading the plague of happiness too far.
So how goes getting rid of that government?
I mean, it's a matter of time, basically. It's, let's see. How long do I have it? January 20th, 1938. So half a year.
Okay, I think we can turn the speed up.
Okay.
Thank you. I just need one more city from them.
From the directory, or which one?
The directory.
But no damage.
Right.
You wouldn't be able to send me volunteers, would you?
I would have to spend, like, all of my stability to do it. Economic devolution. It is absurd to think that some bureaucrat in Paris should... knows what is best for a company in Bordeaux. We must trust our entrepreneurs and empower them to create their own solutions. Like, in order to help to send volunteers.
Because I can't hold the directory down with these volunteers.
Hey, Ticketator, how's it going, man? Volunteers. Allow volunteers. your work, which gets event volunteers from France. I would spend 20 stability. Oh, that'd give manpower. Covert intervention. That would... that's 25 stability. Then volunteer tension limit minus 90%. What? How could I... Could I do that right now? Some... Like, where... What's the... And volunteers. We need world tension at 50%, currently 5. Our world tension limit on this action due to democratic was 50%. I think I would be able to do it. Is there, like, it would hurt. Like, that would basically cut my production in half.
Okay.
Yeah, it's been a while. How you been, Tickenator? Like, maybe when I get rid of disjointed government. I have not taken the politically stable path. Alright, and it's still gonna... I'm doing improved worker conditions, but... That's only... Like, I've still got 107 days for that one to finish before I think I could do another one.
Okay, I might be able to do it.
I took Sevilla. No Malaga. Alright, you got Cadiz though, that's great.
Yeah, if I can make it to Gibraltar, I think I've taken out the directory. But I'm not going to be able to do it.
It may just take a bit more time.
I need one city somewhere. Okay, I think I've got it.
Nice. Oh, there you go.
Okay, that once again screwed up my front line. So let's get that fixed.
Okay. Yeah, Greece is the Hellenic Republic right now.
Cool. Okay, let's see if I can get rid of the Republic now.
Attention. Gardez vos rangs.
All right, you're getting them.
Not making much progress against the anarchists, but...
You'll have another front once you've dealt with the Republicans. You could always try naval invasions.
Dude, it's taking everything I have just to keep the front line staffed. I've got no extra troops.
All right.
Oh.
Yeah, you're
take
almost
a look at what's unguarded.
Yeah, you got Valencia?
I'm about to just walk into it.
Excellent. There you go. Nice. Ooh. A good little puncture. Like if you got a faster unit, you could send it just run up to Barcelona. If you got no cav.
I don't think I have any cav left. I think the Phalange got them all.
Dang. What's a king without a horse? But I think a push up along the coast could be just what you need.
Yeah. Well, at the very least, I don't have to worry about German volunteers anymore.
Yeah.
I should probably do something about the 0% stability.
Yeah.
Promote entrepreneurship. The beating heart of a dynamic market has always been the individual who, upon seeing an opportunity, moves quickly to exploit it. In recent years, the spirit has been smothered with unnecessary regulations. We should roll them back. You're doing all right here. You're doing all right. Communist influence foreign policy. You should embrace our common causes, I guess. Whatever. Now, communist China likes me more. Hooray. Sexy Mao.
Oh, did they?
What was that?
They keep Mao?
They have so far. Can't tell what path they've... If they have worked on any of the paths at all. And Mexico is getting the phalangist veterans.
The what?
The phalangist veterans.
Oh.
Thank you.
écoutez. Écoutez. Gardez vos rangs.
Ah, he beat me.
Oh, you're getting real close, though. You grab, like, Kespe. Oh, hmm. I mean, you're definitely getting in there, though. Barcelona may not be quite enough, but it'd be a very good prize. But once you win this, we should call it there.
Okay.
Alrighty, got a good surround. And Schmecklement.
is a talk on national security. Because the nub of the whole purpose of your president is to keep you now and your children later and your grandchildren much later out of a last-ditch war for the preservation of American independence and of all the things that American independence means.
And there's the remilitarization.
Masters of Germany have made it clear that they intend not only to dominate all life and thought in their own country, but also to enslave the whole of Europe, and then to use the resources of Europe to dominate the rest of the world. States has no right or reason to encourage talk of peace until the day shall come when there is a clear intention on the part of the aggressor nations to abandon all thought of dominating or conquering the world. The forces of the states that are leagued against all people.
I think once I take Barcelona, they surrender.
Hopefully.
And Barcelona is 30 victory points, and their others are one.
Gotcha. Yeah, not long now.
Frankly and definitely, there is danger ahead. Danger against which we must prepare. But we well know that we cannot escape danger or the fear of it by crawling into bed and pulling the covers over our heads. Germany has said that she was occupying Belgium to save the Belgians from the British. Would she hesitate then to say to any South American country, we are occupying you to protect you from aggression by the United States? Belgium is being used as an invasion base against Britain, now fighting for its life. Any South American country in Nazi hands would always
the day ticks.
Jumping off place for Germany.
That should be it.
There we go. Carlist victory in the Spanish Civil War. Carlist forces under Manuel Falcone have finally defeated their phalangist and republican enemies and secured full control over Spain. These fanatics continue to live in the Middle Ages. With the war over, however, many Carlists impatiently await when their efforts are rewarded and the rightful Carlist claimant will at last ascend the Spanish throne. Cool! All right then. I think we'll just go ahead and just go and let the year tick, and then we'll once January shows up, we'll end it. Doing all right. Good job. Really pulled that one out.
Recovering from the Civil War is brutal.
Yeah.
Well, the good news is my stability isn't zero anymore.
Excellent. Yeah, mine is 68%.
I'm at 21. Okay, why the hell did my navy flee to the North Atlantic Ridge?
It's Christmas. It's no longer Christmas. Well, I can modify my government now. Look at that. We'll want to do that. What am I going to spend political power on? Definitely increasing stability more. I mean, getting rid of disjointed government would help a lot. Maybe that's up to 78. Yeah, I think just getting more political power in order to do stuff probably be better. So, silent workhorse. Alright, well, it is January. You've gotten your Civil War dealt with, and I've dug myself out of a hole, somewhat. And it will be not too long before I can repeal the Law of Exile. Just until 20 days. Like, on the 20th, it will be removed. Looking good. Alright, so that'll be it for tonight. I'm very hungry. So, until next time, thank you guys very much for joining me. Rock over London, rock on Chicago. I am Cy Rock Omega, and have a nice day. Later. Yeah?
Well, that was a clusterfuck.
Yeah. Alright, if you're new, be sure to follow the channel, play more of this, the multiplayer, next week, maybe my single player campaign, probably tomorrow now. So, check it out! I gotta restart as Grease because I failed, bye!